Children, let us pray. Our great Father in heaven, thank you so much for today that you have given to us. Thank you that today we may be able to sing new songs, dance again, and we will be able to learn new memory verse and Bible story. Thank you for this privilege. I pray, Lord, that you may help us to understand everything that we're going to do today. Thank you so much. This is my prayer. In Jesus' name, amen. Hello, children. How are you? You know what? We have memorized a lot of memory verses until now, right? And today, I am going to teach you another memory verse. But before that, I want to teach you the difference between needs and wants. What do we mean by needs and what do we mean by wants? Needs, these are the things that will help our lives go longer so that we will not die soon. Without these needs, I think many people would not live a little longer. And however, wants, these are the things that even though without it, we can live our life. So now, children, I want to give you 5-second activity. But before that, I will give you the instructions. Okay, first, do not tell it with your friend or with your family right now. And I want you to think of the things that you need and you want. And I will give you 5 minutes to think about that, okay? 5 seconds, I'm sorry. Okay, so have you thought about your needs and wants? Okay, that's good. Children, do you think I have the ability to read what's on your mind and know what you are thinking? Of course, no. I cannot do that. But you know what? There is someone who knows what is going inside your mind. Let us know who he is through our memory verse, which can be found in our Bible. Okay, so I have my Bible here. The Bible is the Word of God. It means that everything that you can read here is true. It means that we really have to believe in it and apply it into our lives. So I will show you how to find our memory verse for today, and after that I will read it here and we will read it together in the from the screen. Okay, so our memory verse can be found in the New Testament. It is in the book of Matthew chapter 6 verse 8. It says here, your Father knows what you need before you ask him. Okay, now let us read it together in our screen. It says here, Matthew chapter 6 verse 8. Your Father knows what you need before you ask him. Okay, now that we have read the memory verse, let me ask you, who is the one who knows what is going on inside your mind? Yes, that's right. He is God, our Father in heaven. He knows what is going inside your mind. So now let us know the meaning of the memory verse. In the first part, it says here, your Father knows what you need. So the things that we need are food, clothing, a shelter to live, a water to drink. Without those things, maybe we will be dead soon, right? But our Father provides all of those because we are His children. But not only those things, our God also knows our needs when it comes to our feelings and emotions. Sometimes, even though you're still a kid, you feel sad, right? You feel angry, you feel confused, and God knows that. And God knows what you need. If you're sad, God knows what you need to become happy. If you're angry, God knows that you need to be calm so that you'll know the reason of your anger. And if you're confused, God will give you, God will make it clear to you why you are confused, and then you will understand the things that is happening around you. Because God knows what is going on with your life, because He is a powerful God, right? Okay, in the next part, it says here, before you ask Him. You know what, children? Even before you close your eyes to pray, or even before you open your mouth to ask God of what you need, God already knows it. Why? Because He is so powerful and He is alive. So, God wants you to trust in Him. Now that you know the meaning of our memory verse, let us recite it again. It says here, Matthew chapter 6 verse 8, your Father knows what you need before you ask Him. Now, for all the children who do not know Jesus Christ yet and have not accepted Him as their Savior from the punishment of their sins, God wants you to know that the greatest thing that you need right now is God to be your heavenly Father and for you to become His child. How? Teacher, how will I be a child of God? How will God be my Father? You will be a child of God if you accepted Jesus Christ as the Savior from the punishment of your sins. So later in our Bible story, you will know more who Jesus Christ is and you will get to understand how you can be a child of God and how God can be your heavenly Father. And for those children who know Jesus Christ now and have accepted Him as their Savior and Lord, God wants to remind you that He loves you. God loves you so much. Because God loves you, He cares for you, He knows your needs, and He is rich enough to provide all your needs. You just have to surrender your life and trust in Him. So now, children, I prepared a mini activity to help you memorize our memory verse. So I'm going to raise three fingers to show you, to direct you the volume of your voices. If I raise only one finger, it means that you're going to recite the memory verse in a very low voice. But if I raise two fingers, it means that you're going to recite the memory verse with a normal voice. And if I raise three fingers, you're going to recite the memory verse with a loud voice. Okay? Okay, so I cut the memory verse into two. Okay, so first, how many fingers are raised? Okay, two fingers. Therefore, we're going to recite it in a normal voice. Your father knows what you need. Okay, next. Oh, we're going to use a very loud voice. Your Father knows what you need. The next. Okay, a very low voice. Your Father knows what you need. Okay, now let's go to the second part of the memory verse. So we're going to use a very loud voice. Before you ask Him. Next. Okay, how many fingers are raised? Oh, only one. So we're going to use a low voice. Before you ask Him. Next, we're going to use a normal voice. Before you ask Him. Okay, so I hope that you are now familiar with the two parts of our memory verse. So now, let us recite it again. It says here, Matthew chapter 6 verse 8. Your Father knows what you need before you ask Him. Now, we're going to recite it in a very low voice. Matthew chapter 6 verse 8. Your Father knows what you need before you ask Him.
Children, do you remember last month we have celebrated the Father's Day, right? Can you tell me what kind of gifts did you give to your fathers? Wow, those are very wonderful gifts, children. And I know maybe some of you gave letters to them or only greeted them, but that's not a problem because it's all kinds or those are all on how we can express our love to our fathers. So why do we give it to them? Because we love our fathers a lot, right? First of all, because they are the ones who work for our families. They are the one who work hard outside even though it's hot. They give their best so they will earn money so that we can eat the food that we want, we can have the dress or the toys that we want. So fathers are very, very important in a family. But did you know, children, that in our story today, there's very sad thing that happened in one of the families in the Bible, because their father or the father of this family had died. Although it did not said in the Bible how the father had died, but the Bible explained how or what happened to the family that was left. So the only thing or the only people left are the mother and the two sons or two children. Now, because they don't have a father or her husband anymore, so there is no one who bring money to the house. So all they do is to borrow money from other people. Now, one day, these collectors came to their house and said that if the next time we go to your house, you still don't have money, we will get your children and make them as our slaves. So because of that, children, the widow became very, very sad and she cried a lot. So she tried to find something in their house that maybe she can sell so that she can give the money to the collectors. But sad thing is that they don't have anything left. And the only thing they have is a very small jar of olive oil. So this widow cried and cried a lot. She's worried what they will eat. She's worried where can she get the money to give to the collectors. And just like this widow, children, I know that you are also worried sometimes. Maybe you saw that, especially now in this pandemic, a lot of people have lost their jobs. Maybe one of them are your parents. Maybe you're worrying, what food will you eat, right? Maybe you're worrying about your house. Maybe some of you, especially now that it is raining a lot, maybe you have a very not good roof where if it rains a lot, water will drip down from it. Or maybe you are living in a house where it get easily flooded. Or maybe some of you, especially those who are still students, maybe you are worrying about the coming semester because there will be, of course, new modules, new assignments to answer, right? So all these things might make you worry. But do you still remember a memory verse earlier? Yes, it says here in Matthew 6 verse 8, it says there, "For your father knows what you need before you ask him." So it means, children, that God our Father already knows what you need, but still he wants you to ask it from him. It means that he wants you to pray to him, children. He wants you to ask for help, just like this widow. So this widow, since they have nothing left except for this small jar, she prayed and prayed to God asking for help. And do you know what happened, children? That's right, God answered her prayer. And how? So God sent Elisha to this widow and her family to answer or to give solution to their problem. So when Elisha met the widow, he told her what to do. So he gave her instructions. He told her to go around their neighborhood, ask for an empty jars, and once they get it, go inside their house, lock the doors, lock the window, and then pour the remaining olive oil to the empty jar. So at first, the widow cannot understand why did Elisha want her to get empty jars from, from her neighbors. But this widow children, she believes and trusts in God. And she knows that what Elisha is telling her is the answer that she prayed for to God. So children, we all know that Elisha was sent to her by God because God loves her so much. And just like how much God loves the widow, He also loves you children. Why? Because He is the one who created you. And that is why He wants you to be with Him forever in heaven. But the problem is, you and I, everybody are born to be sinners. So it means that all the people on earth have sinful heart. They want to do bad things. They want to do the things that are not pleasing to God. That's why it says in the Bible, in Isaiah 59 verse 2, shall we read it all together? Okay, very good. So let's read it all together. Ready, start. Isaiah 59 verse 2, but your iniquities have separated you from your God. So according to this verse, children, because of our sin, we cannot be with God. But just like what I've told you earlier, because God loves you so much, He wants to save you from your sin. And by doing that, He gave His one and only Son, Jesus Christ, to come down here on earth, to live as a human just like us. And the first is for us to be forgiven. He took the punishment for our sins. And what was that punishment? That's right. It is the death on the cross. So because God loves you so much, and Jesus loves you so much, He died on the cross even though He is sinless. He did not do anything wrong. But because He loves you so much, that's why He sacrificed His life for you. It says in Colossians chapter 3 verse 20, it says there that by making peace through His blood, or His blood shed on the cross. So it says here, children, that through the blood of Jesus Christ on the cross, that's why we are now in peace with God. So, and that happens because of God's love for you. And just like how God loves you, He also loves the widow and His children. That is why He sent Elisha to this family. Now, even though they don't understand what was happening, but still they obeyed Elisha. So this widow asked her sons to go around their neighborhood and ask for an empty jars. And probably a lot of their neighbors know the situation of the widow and their children. So they wanted to help too. So they gave the empty jars that they have to this widow. And after that, so when they received all these empty jars, they went. So this widow and her children went inside the house. They locked the door. They locked the window. They made sure that no one can see them. And after that, they pour out the oil or the olive oil onto the empty jars. And did you know what happened, children? There's a very wonderful thing that happened, because all these empty jars are filled with olive oil. So the widow only poured, do you remember? It's a small piece of olive oil, right? But this small piece of olive oil were able to fill all the empty jars that they have received from their neighbors. So it's not stopping. So this child or her child said, when her child said that, "Mom, it's the last jar." And that was the only time that the oil from the jar, her jar, stopped on pouring. And they were so amazed and they were so happy when they saw all those empty jars that are filled with olive oil. So this woman or this widow ran to Elisha, very happy because she now have the solution to their problem. Now, by selling this olive oil, they can get the money to pay to the collectors of the debt. And at the same time, they now also have the money to buy for their own, for their daily life, right? Like, for example, they have money to buy for food, for clothes, and other things. So this widow is very, very happy to say that to Elisha. And after that, so they returned to their house and they started selling the olive oil to the people. And the money they received, they give it to the collectors, and the rest, they have kept it so that they will have money to spend for the future. It's very wonderful, right, children? We have seen how much God takes care of His people. He showed how much He loves those who trust in Him. So I hope, children, that just like this widow and her children, I hope that you also will trust in God. No matter what kind of problem you have right now, I hope you will trust in God and always remember that He is listening to your prayer. So this time, let us pray. Father God, thank you for this day that you gave to us. Help us to become like the widow who trusted you with all her heart. So help us also that although we have a lot of problems right now, we have a lot of things that we are worrying about, but help us, Lord, to trust fully in you and believe that you will help us all the time. This is our prayer in Jesus' name. Amen. Man.